This is for U12 methods. It comes out of 1C, types of functions and implied domains, and I apologise for all the background noise. When we have implied domains, there are three conditions that will give us our implied domain. One of them is the division by zero, and that's not possible. Another one is the square root of a negative number. And the third one is you can't take the logarithms of zero or negative numbers. So I'm going to go through 8a, b, c, and d. Okay, in 8a, I've got a denominator. Therefore, this can't equal zero. So x minus 3 cannot equal zero, which means x cannot equal 3. So the implied domain is all real numbers except for 3. In part B, I've got x squared minus 3 underneath the square root. Therefore, this can't be negative. X squared minus 3 has to be bigger than or equal to 0. Now, I'm going to graph this to see where it's positive and where it's negative. So it's a parabola. It goes through here at negative 3. Therefore, that's root 3. That's negative root 3. Where is it bigger than 0? It's bigger than 0 up here, which means bigger than root 3, or up here, which is less than negative root 3. And it can't be down here, because when down here is where it's negative. So my domain will be negative infinity to negative root 3 inclusive, union with root 3 to infinity. Looking at question part C, this bit under here, this bit under the square root has to be positive. So x squared plus 3 has to be bigger than or equal to 0. I'm going to graph this and see that goes through at 3. It's always bigger than 0. So any value of x will give you x squared plus 3 bigger than 0, so therefore you can take the square root. So my domain is all real numbers. Now, for part D, I've got two conditions, like two different things being added together. In this particular domain, x minus 4 has to be bigger than or equal to 0, so x bigger than or equal to 4. And this is an 11 minus x has to be bigger than or equal to 0, which means minus x is bigger than or equal to minus 11. Or x is less than or equal to positive 11. Notice I'm turning the positive sign around when I divide it by negative 1. So from 4 up, 11 down, the overlap is between 4 and 11. So my domain is 4 through to 11. So when you're trying to work out domains and you have something like a quadratic, draw a graph and see where the condition falls.